Hello and welcome to azurewala YouTube channel. We are in part 35 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 65 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 66. You have an Azure subscription that contains a user named user1. You need to ensure that user1 can deploy virtual machines and manage virtual networks. So two tasks: first is deployment of virtual machine, second is manage virtual network. The solution must use the principle of least privilege. We should not give the privilege which is not required. So which role-based access control role should you assign to user1? So first we will understand what's the owner, virtual machine, contributor, and virtual machine administrator logon. So let's move to definitions. So first one is owner role. Owner role is having full access to all the resources and can delegate the access to others as well. So it's like full authority to any resource available as an owner. Next one is contributor, which is little bit less than owner. So let's see, create and manage all type of Azure resources, create a new tenant in Azure Active Directory, and cannot grant access to others. So this is the only limitation compared to owner one. Next one is virtual machine contributor. Virtual machine contributor can create and manage virtual machines, manage disks, install and run software, reset password of a root user of virtual machines using virtual machine extensions, and manage local user accounts using virtual machine extensions. This role does not grant you management access to the virtual network or storage account in the virtual machines are connected to. This role does not allow you to assign role in Azure role-based access control as well. The last role is given virtual machine administrator login. It can view virtual machine in the Azure portal and can login as administrator to the virtual machine. So as per our question, user one can deploy the virtual machines and manage virtual network. So if we see the owner is having full access, therefore definitely it can do the job. The second one is virtual machine contributor, which is limited to virtual machine, and having this role, user cannot manage any network or storage of the account, so it definitely cannot work. Next one is contributor. And contributor can do everything, means can manage the resource, also create a new tenant in an Active Directory as well. So definitely contributor can manage this one as well. Virtual machine administrator login, definitely this role only allows to login to as administrator to virtual machine and can view the virtual machine in Azure portal, so this will not be helpful. Now from A and C, we have to determine which is the having least possible privileges which can do the job for us. So definitely owner can do the job, but lesser than the owner, we do have contributor having least privileges which we need for this case. Therefore the answer is C is correct actually as per the question. However, owner can also do the same job, but as we need the principle of least privilege here in this question, therefore C is the correct answer. Let's move to next question. Question number 67. You have an Azure subscription named subscription 1 that contains a Azure virtual machine named VM1. VM1 is in a resource group named resource group 1. VM1 runs services that will be used to deploy resources to RG1. You need to ensure that service running on virtual machine 1 can manage the resources in resource group 1 by using identity of virtual machine 1. This is very important here. We have to understand the concept of identity. So that only will make us enable to manage the resource in resource group 1. So before we answer this question, let's understand the concept of identity. Managed identity for Azure resource. Managed identity for Azure resources provide Azure services with an automatic managed identity in Azure Active Directory. So that's what important. This is what it provides, identity in Azure Active Directory. You can use this identity to authenticate. That's what important term is. Why we are going to have identity for any resource? So we can authenticate to any service that support Azure Active Directory authentication. So with having this identity attached to the resource, we can automatically can authenticate on any service which requires the authentication without having any credential. So there is no need of credential. Automatically virtual machine or whatever resource we do have, we can authenticate having this identity in Azure Active Directory. Two types of identities are available in Azure for any resource. So first one is system assigned and second is user assigned. A system assigned managed identity is restricted to one identity per resource. So it is only restricted, or it is only the unique identity for each resource, and is tied to life cycle of the resource. If resource is deleted, identity also will get deleted. You can grant permissions to manage identity by using Azure role-based access control. The managed identity is authenticated with Azure Active Directory, so you don't have to store any credential. This is what the greatest advantage of having identity. Second is user assigned identity. User assigned managed identity enables Azure resources to authenticate to cloud services without storing credentials in code. This type of managed identities are created as standalone Azure resources and have their own lifecycle. So only difference between system assigned is this identity is tied up with the resource itself and its resource lifecycle, while a user assigned one is not tied up with the resource. It is having its own lifecycle. A single resource can utilize multiple user assigned managed identities. So one resource can have multiple user assigned identities, and similarly a single user assigned managed identity can have shared across multiple resources. So in user assigned identity case, one resource may have multiple user assigned identities. One user assigned identities can have multiple resources. Let's quickly go to Azure portal as well to understand this concept. We are in Azure portal now. We have resource group created, resource group 1. Resource group 1 has a user identity created in it, and we do have one virtual machine VM1 and another virtual machine VM2. So VM1, if I go to virtual machine 1 and if I go to identity tab, I can see it is having system assigned identity and user assigned identity as well. So the status for system assigned identity is on, and it's the one principal ID only. While the user assigned identity, I can manually assign the identity from here by adding the identity to this resource. Similarly, we have created virtual machine 2 where we have no identity or system assigned identity in this case. So we cannot see this resource in Active Directory, but still we have user assigned identity which we have created, and we have manually assigned it by adding from here. So I will again show you in the Active Directory that how it looks like. So if I go here and I go to enterprise applications, I remove the filter, and if I search VM1, since it is having system assigned identity, I can view this resource. But if I go to VM2, is not having any system assigned identity, so I cannot view it. But same time I have assigned its custom identity, so user identity 1 is assigned to this one, so that identity I can view here, and VM2 is associated with this identity. So this is how identity works. Let's go back to question. As per our question, virtual machine 1 runs a service that deploys resource in resource group 1. Therefore, virtual machine 1 shall have an identity associated with this, and that is going to have, you know, resource deployment on resource group 1. So if we provide identity to virtual machine 1, it will do the job. So let's see the answers. So D, we'll start from the D. Azure portal modify policy setting. Policies setting have nothing to do with the virtual machine identity in this case. Option C, from the Azure portal modify the access control. It has nothing to do with the access control, that is for providing the access to any user. And B is also having the same access control to resource group 1. Resource group 1 is not going to run any service, the virtual machine is going to run the service. Therefore, we should be talking about virtual machine. Option A, from the Azure portal modify the managed identity settings of virtual machine 1. Definitely this is how we have, you know, gone through all the definitions and Azure portal, that we can associate one managed identity with virtual machine, and that identity can be used to authenticate on resource group 1 and can do the job what we are expecting to do. So examiner's intention here is to test that we understand the concept of identity and how it authenticates to use any resource, or you know, work on any resource. So I hope this is clear to you. Also, in the exam we have to keep in mind that if any resource is running any service and requires any authentication on resource group or any other resource, we have to keep in mind that in that case only managed identity will work. So no IAM or any policies etc. will work in that case. I hope this video was informative for you. Please like, subscribe, press the bell notification icon, share with your friends. Thank you for watching this video, and see you next video.